Now 50 years given patient having tender dysplasia. Okay. Here you can see, clinically you can see there is discontinuity and swelling. Okay, this is the swelling. You can see. And this is the normal size. You can see continuity of here. Here discontinuity is there. Clinically you can confirm it with Thompson's test. The test is usually first I will do in normal size. While squeezing calf muscle, there is plantar section of foot. You can observe while squeezing, there is a plantar section. Okay. This is a defect in. While squeezing the calf muscle, there is no continuity, so there is no plantar section of foot. This is one of the commonly used tests to diagnose tendinitis rupture. There are another test also, Mantel's test, Neville O'Brien test, single hair rise test. There are lot of other tests. Now I am palpating medial border of the tendinitis. Okay. First I will mark it. This is the medial border. And give longitudinal incision just medial to the tendinitis. This is the tendinitis, just medial. Why I am giving medial to the tendinitis is to prevent post-operative skin adhesions and skin scarring. Better healing will be there. If I give post or lateral incision, chances of injury to sural nerve will be more and less likely saphenous nerve. So I am giving incision to the just medial aspect of tendinitis. This is the superficial incision. After that, I will dissect.
Okay. Yeah.
Here is the cut. You can see this is the proximal part of the tendinitis. There should be continuity. This one is looking like chronic. Patient had sustained injury more than 1 month ago. Initially she was telling just 10 days ago, but after looking here I can say this is more than 1 month. Now I have confirmed with the patient, she is telling it is more than 1 month. Okay. Now I have to ligate, I have to fashion with the edges, then I have to ligate to the distal part. Okay. After cleaning, I will ligate this. Okay. Considering the proximal side, I'm suturing through. I am using the technique of modified Kessler. There are lot of other techniques like Bennell's. Here I am using modified Kessler. I have tried for a bond suture material, but I couldn't get it. So I am suturing with proline. One number proline I am using now. Usually I use Epibond 30 or 40. Modified Kessler suture technique. Okay. have done the suturing, proximal part and distal part. Here is the tear site. This is the tear site. Now you can see continuation of the tendon is there now. Distally there was very less space. So if I do squeeze this, you can observe plantar section of foot is there. So that means continuity of the tendon is present now. Suturing of the tendon is done. Now I wash the wound and I close it. Then after closing the wound, I apply clamp from the dorsum of the foot. Okay, by keeping the ankle in plantar section like this. I'll apply the clamp for 3 to 4 minutes.